word, I fail the son of God, so certainly do it and prove it.
Now it will come about in the last days, the mountain of the house of the Lord will be established as the chief of the mountains, and will be raised above the hills, and all the nations will stream to it.
And many people will come and say, come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us concerning his ways, and that we may walk in his paths, for the law will go forth from Zion. Word of the Lord from Jerusalem.
And he will judge between the nations and will render decisions for many peoples. And they will hammer their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation will not lift up sword against nation, and never again will they learn war.
Come, house of Jacob, and let us walk in the light of the Lord.
Matthew 3:1-6. Now in those days, John the Baptist came, preaching in the wilderness of Judea, saying,
repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
For this is the one referred to by Isaiah the prophet, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, make ready the way of the Lord, make his path straight.
Now John himself had a garment of camel's hair and a leather belt about his waist, and his food was locusts and wild honey.
Then Jerusalem was going out to him and all Judea, and all the district around Jordan.
And they were being baptized by him in the Jordan River, as they confessed their sins.
Shall we pray? As we prepare for the coming of your Son, let us reflect your life in all that we say and do. Give us the strength to change our ways, rid ourselves of angry thoughts, bitter words, and selfishness, and anything that distracts us from your light in us. O Jesus, our hearts are open.
Precious Jesus, God's own. there was light.
For many years, the
the bitter cold of Constitution Island on the Hudson River in New York, where two sisters, Susan and Anna B. Warner, resided and wrote for a living. They warmed their hearts with their love for God's Word. For over 40 years, they taught the Bible to many of the West Point cadets. Among Anna B.'s writings, she left us a legacy of love, the words to the most beloved song, Jesus Loves Me. As you listen to our children sing, let the simple yet profound words of God's gift of Christmas love reel in your heart.
Tells us that God sent the angel Gabriel to Mary, a virgin living in Nazareth, engaged to bear Mary to Joseph. Fear not, Gabriel told Mary. You are highly favored and chosen by God. You will be overshadowed by the power of the Holy Spirit and will conceive a child, God's only son. You shall call his name Jesus. Mary trusted God.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Son Jesus. He chose to leave his throne and heavenly home and come to earth and live with us. He would cry as a baby, grow as a child, and learn as a son.
Jesus would die upon a cruel cross as a sinless and blameless man. He would be the sacrificial lamb of God, dying for you and for me. Our response to such a lavish act of love can only be to say, thank you for the cross. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for your gift of love.
Thank you. Aye.
Boy, if you're failing your part now. If you have never accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as God's Son, if you have never asked Him to be your Savior, I can't think of a better time to do it. And when we come to celebrate the birth of Jesus, it says here that the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, for there was no room in the inn. And they were in the same region, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And the angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And the angel said, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you this day is born in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." The Lord has come. And in the 11th chapter of the Gospel according to Matthew, Jesus makes this statement and says, "Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly of heart, and you shall find rest for your souls." This morning, we want to invite you to come and accept Christ as your Savior. If you've never done that, that's the most important decision any person will ever make, is to let Christ come in. There's no name given under heaven among men whereby you must be saved except the name of Jesus. We invite you to come to Him. Perhaps you're a Christian. You live in this community, but you don't have a church home where you live. You've moved everything else in your household and set up your home here. Wouldn't you move your relationship with the Lord and with His church? Come and join the church today. You can join on statement of faith. You can join on profession of your faith. Or you can join this morning by transfer of your membership. We invite you to do that. We're going to sing an invitation hymn. And while we sing this invitation, if you need to come this morning, would you come? Don't hesitate. God's word says, now is the accepted time, and today is the day of salvation. There's no better time than right now for you to do it. Would you stand with me? And we're going to sing an invitation, and we invite you to come while we sing. Thank you. singing and the music this morning. And we are so grateful that we have one who has come. And I don't have all the information just yet, but she's about to get it done. But we want to welcome you to the service. If you are a guest, would you be happy to be seated? And if you are a guest in our service, we are so glad that you come. And we hope that you've got a blessing, and we'd invite you to come back. We'll even invite you to come back tonight. We're going to have an evening service at 6:30, and we'll be worshiping the Lord. And tonight I'm going to preach on the work of the Holy Spirit. And we hope that you'll come and share in that service with us. Benny, come up here and stand by me, would you? All right. We need to get someone that'll come and stand with me. Would you do that? All right. Peggy's going to do it. Thank you, Peggy. All right. This is Minnie Coles. And she goes by Dee Dee. Okay? And she lives in New Braunfels, but she comes. She said she has accepted Christ as her Savior 40 years ago. And amen. And she has followed the Lord in baptism. And she would like to come and be a part of our church on statement of her faith in Christ. So, if you rejoice in her coming and you accept her into the fellowship of our church as she has come, I won't just give a good hearty amen.
Amen.
All right. Now, when the choir is going to sing a finale, and then I'm going to ask Peggy and Benny to stand up here, and you come by and greet her. Now, tell her who you are. She won't remember. But you need to let people know. I guess the last folks that come and join was George and Wanda. Have you learned everybody's name yet, George?
Yeah.
All right. And so it's kind of awkward sometimes when somebody comes up, they greet you and talk to you, and you don't know who you're talking to. So you be sure and let her know who you are. God bless you. Now, our choir is going to sing the finale right now. And y'all want to sing?
Father God, we thank you for Christmas. We thank you for your son, Jesus. As we go from this place celebrating the season, may your love shine through us. May your joy fill our hearts with renewed hope and childlike wonder. May your voice speak peace and calm all our fears. Lord, let your grace and mercy rest upon us. May we allow Christmas to change us and make us more like Jesus. And may we always have thankful